stay over here, Grace.
Okay.
No, not really.
Nah.
Couple minor things I just mentioned. So for the future. So obviously we like the dog to be young farmer. I like the dog, you know, anxious about going on, right, and excited, and that's all good. But just a little calmer there. When you walk up to the sand pad, make sure you go all the way to the sand pad too. So okay. If the dog kind of chases ahead of you, you know, try to go with it. So it's like some they hear prepared and let the dog go to the sand pad and figure it out. That's not okay. So basically you prepare your dog, you have still on like a short leash. If you need to prepare and put the leash underneath, which I probably would do, especially with a dog that speed, because when the dog is that fast and you hold a little bit, if you have the leash on top here, you basically lift the head up, right? If you have it underneath, you might be better off and you keep the dog a little bit. With that speed, you basically need to keep it tight and keep it a little shorter. Not shorter, but a little, you know, keep the dog from running that much. So when you do that, you walk all the way up to the sand pad.
Okay.
And when you're at the sand pad, then you say soothe and then you let the fish go. Okay? So really minor detail. In general, obviously like the dog to be a little calmer. Speed is not a big issue. Some dogs are really slow, some a little fast. It's not an issue if the intensity is there. But you can tell sometimes it's just more like hectic and it's not really intense. In the beginning it was still nice, but then later on you can see the head coming up and here and there. And because of that speed, then you kind of, the dog's losing it. And then the dog starts sort of really concentrating on seeing, trying to find it. It's kind of like really kind of running around, right? Getting faster and faster. So you have a lot of like circling there. And obviously you get some corrections, end of the leash here too. If that happens once, normally the judge can tell you, well, next time you follow your dog, right? So with the one, obviously, we'll try to be a little nicer. But then the dog finally gets like to the article, like luckily, like we like, oh, there's an article.
Yeah.
And then, so we have kind of a new starting point, which was good. But that part there, that whole section there, obviously, was not on track, right? Then the second part of that leg was better again. But then we always shoot the corner a little bit and have a little circling again, but then the dog picks it up later. And then here, you just want to get to the end, right? So you get faster and faster, you start running.
I didn't want to correct her again.
I can see that. I totally get that. But be careful. There's one between, you know, kind of keep her going and be fast and running, right?
Okay.
So when you start running, then it's really like, you know, it'll cost you. So again, with the one, really good about it, but try to find that right line between holding the dog and, you know, not correcting and holding her back. Shay, right?
Yeah.
Shay. Sorry. They're so long there, so like,
that's
which
okay.
one? Which one?
It's Shay.
Okay. On the healing, we have a little fortune, a little wide in the healing, a little distraction here and there. The about turn definitely can be better, right? And then it's kind of sitting late, so when you stop, the dog should right away stop and sit there. The dog is kind of late and then ahead of you there. Most of these are coming, oh, relaxing, isn't it? Most is kind of where more attention probably would help. You know, some of these come out of not having enough attention and focus on there. And because of that, then it's just late on responding to some of those commands and turns. But it's still, it's not bad. It's definitely not a failing. It's a borderline. It's a good still for me. They sit out of motion. I would say a very good exercise. What still can be improved mainly is the build-up, which is the healing part. So there's a little more focus, a little better healing on that. The down out of motion, here too, the build-up could be just a little better in healing. And then the dog is crooked in front and crooked in the finish, should be better positioning. A little bump coming in as well, might could be a little cleaner.
That was a good bump for her. You should have knocked me over.
Well, there we go. So it was good. All right. The retrieve on the flat, start should be calmer. The dog should be really calm in the basic position until the dog gets the command. Then we get some like parking and
like enthusiastic. She likes her dumb dog.
So that's the good thing. The dog's really excited about the work, so, and that's good. Just need a little more control with it. But then there's a lot of like playing with the dumbbell, you know, the taking and playing. So that's definitely something you need to try to get out and calm that down. Then we have, in addition, they're crooked too. That goes for most of the exercises where the dog is just not really correct in the positioning. You know, like crooked in front, crooked in the finish, those kind of things that can be cleaned up. That's, again, those are the things which goes with all the different exercises, you know, you have it in all the recalls, you have it on all the retrieve routines. So if you don't get clean positioning, then it adds up, you know, even if it's just a half, but it's a half and a half and a half and a half, and you know, all of a sudden it adds up to 6 points, you know. So on the retrieve over the jump, you get a little sit command there, right at the beginning, before you throw it. Probably knowing that the dog wants to leave early and is a little restless, so I get that, but obviously it's a head for help. Here too, where we have the playing, we have the crooked sets, I mean, kind of repeats itself. Then we have on the retrieve over the wall, again, here needs to be calmer with the dumbbell, that's crooked in front, crooked in the finish. General place more control.
You see the pattern here.
In the exercise. Yeah. I think we all do, right? But that's good. And that's, you know, that's what we're here for, right?
Yeah.
Learning experience and see what else we can work on, where we can do better for the next truck, how we can prepare better. On the send out, it's a good exercise. Couple things there too. I like to see a little more attention there in the build up again there, the healing part. The dog is just doing its own thing, but not even looking at you or anything.
I know,
like
I'm
that.
Not even part of the.
No, it's like I do my thing, like, oh, you're here too? So, and then I would consider that a handheld, not just me, but in general, it is a handheld. So it should be when you do your send out, you should be doing it out of like a normal, like, right, like this. But when you see probably 8 out of 10 people, it's kind of like, you know, you almost like you try to really push your dog forward. Really, mostly it doesn't really help you much anyway. It might be even destructive to the dog, because if the dog doesn't want to go or doesn't know what to do, it probably wouldn't help you much doing it. So just try to get used. But if you do it always in training, then maybe the dog starts relying on it, and it's a habit, right? So see in training that you can just do it kind of more like, you know, do it like the normal way.
Okay,
right?
Not so dramatic.
But it still was a good exercise, but that easily could be a very good exercise for the dog. Okay. When he came back on the long down,
make sure, so you go back there, you get your position, you wait for me, then I tell you, then you do the sit, and then you stay in that position until the dog is done with the send out. That's how correctly the procedure should be. There should not be like downing the dog or something like that.
The dog is in a sit while he's doing a send out? Okay.
Yeah. It's the same like when you go, when you start out, one dog goes in that position, one dog goes that position, and they both are basically in a sit.
Okay.
So any time in between should be in a sit. It's no big deal, I just tell you because
you
want to know ideal, right?
Yeah, you were telling me, and I was like, well, I'm not sure, so
I'll just leave
her the way she is.
And that's why I thought, I just leave it, and we talk about it later.
Okay.
But so I want you to know for the future what the ideal, the correct procedure would be, so if you later, you really, you know, go further and further and go to some championship, every point counts, and they would get you.
Okay.
All right. Good job. 81 points today.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Oh, I imagine. Yeah. Well, those for real dogs are completely different.
I'm in yours. I'm sorry.
Oh, okay.
I'm trying to figure out which one. I think that's my favorite.
You stop that. Go here. Oh, no. Whatever. She got some cool stuff. She's another one with a really good temper. She's a snapper.
Those are levels.
Really nice stuff. He loves this stuff. He's moving.
Back.